fractional numbers and their decimal expansions. In class 9, we have studied that the decimal expansion of a rational number is either terminating or non-terminating recurring. And how to find the decimal expansion of a rational number? Last year, you did it by doing the long division. A rational number p by q means p divided by q. Then using the long division method, the decimal expansion can be find out. And here in this lesson, there are three more results given as theorems that is remaining. And today, through some examples, how can we find out the decimal expansion of a rational number without actual division? Okay, and for that, through some examples, we'll illustrate it. Listen. Consider. First of all, I'll be writing the heading. Revisiting. Numbers and their decimal expansions. Revisiting rational numbers and their decimal expansions. Then, listen, example 1, 0.375. All of you consider this terminating decimal. Okay, and this may be written in its rational form as 375 divided by 1000. 375 divided by 1000, which may be written as 375 divided by 1000. You know that it is 10 cube. Okay, and it is 375 divided by 10 can be written as 2 into 5. The prime factorization of 10 is 2 into 5. Whole raised to 3. Then what should you do next is you have to prime factorize this numerator. And this rational number should be written in the form P by Q, where P and Q are co-prime. Here it is of the form P by Q, but P and Q have common factors other than 1. They are not co-prime. We have to write this in the form P by Q, where P and Q are co-prime. Means in its lowest or simplest form. For that we have to do the prime factorization of 375. 375. Okay. Then as we know the divisibility test, this is an odd number. So the smallest prime, 2, is not a factor. Then check whether 3 is a factor. Yes, 3 plus 7 is 10, 10 plus 5 is 15. Then it is 3 is a factor. Then 375 divided by 3 is 125. Again, 3 is not a factor, only 5. We take, get it as 3 into 5 into 5 into 5. May be written as, okay, here we write 3 into 5 cube by this AB whole raised to M. Can be written as A raised to M into B raised to M. That is 2 cube into 5 cube. Now, to get the simplest form 5 cube and 5 cube, maybe cut, then we get it as 3 by 2 cube. Okay, this is the lowest form of the terminating decimal 0.375. We got it. Then consider another example, that is 0.104. Maybe we can ask 104 by 1000 is equal to 104 by 10 cube is equal to 104 by 2 into 5 cube. Then what to do? You have to prime factorize 104. 104 to be prime factorized. This is an even number, then 2 is a factor. Then we get 52, again 2, 26, again 2, and the last prime factor is 13. Then we can write this as 2 cube into 13 by 2 cube into 5 cube. Then to get the lowest form, 2 cube and 2 cube can cancel. Then it is 13 by 5 cube. We got the P by Q form, where P and Q are co-prime. Co-prime means should not have any common factor other than 1. I think these two examples are clear. Then we will do one more. Okay, the third one, example 3. Let's consider one more, 0.0875. What is the P by Q form of this? 875 divided by, here there are 4 places, therefore 10,000 is equal to 875 divided by 10 raised to 4 is equal to 875 divided by 2 into 5 whole raised to 4. Then what to do? We have to do the prime factorization of 875. Okay, which is the smallest prime factor? 8 plus 7, 15 plus 5, it is 20. So 2 and 3 are not factors. Then we get it as 5. Then what will you get? Okay. 1, 7, 5. Again, 5 will get 35. Then we get 5, 7. So we can write this as 5 cube into 7 by 2 raised to 4 into 5 raised to 4. This is the prime factorization. Then how can we have this here 5 cube and here 5 raised to 4? So 5 cube may be cut from 5 raised to 4, 1 5 is remaining. Then the P by Q form is 7 by 2 raised to 4 into 5. This is the P by Q form in its lowest, that is P and Q are co-prime.
Next theorem, 1.6 is the reverse or
or the converse of theorem 1.5. That is, the p by q form will be given, then we have to find the decimal expansion. It is the converse of 1.5. For that, you consider example 1. Consider a rational number 3 by 8, p by q, where p and q are coprime. Then what about its decimal expansion? In the previous case, the decimals were given. We have written them in the form p by q, where p and q are coprime. And here, in its converse, you are given p by q, and we are going to find its decimal expansion. Let's see. It is 3 by 3 is a prime number already, and its prime factorization is 2 cube. Okay, and in the last year, if you are asked to find the decimal, you are asked to find the decimal expansion. You were dividing 3 divided by 8, use the long division. Here it is not like that. 3 by 2 cube is equal to 3 by, if it is 10 cube, we can write the decimal expansion easily. So, 2 cube may be written as 2 cube into 5 cube. And if you multiply the denominator of a fraction or a rational number by a number, by the same number we have to multiply the numerator also. And here we have multiplied both p and q by 5 cube. Is equal to 3 into 5 cube, you know that it is 125 by, this is 2 cube into 5 cube is 10 cube. Then 3 into 125 is 375 by 10 cube is 1000. We get it as 0.375. And here we can state the converse of the previous theorem 1.5 as if a rational number is given whose denominator q is of the form 2 raised to m, 5 raised to n. Here there is no 5, but we can write it as into 5 raised to 0 we can write. Any number raised to 0 is 1. We can write it like that, 2 cube into 5 raised to 0. Then we see its decimal expansion is terminating. Okay, and the second example, it is 13 by 125. 13 by 125 is equal to 13 by 125, you know that it is 5 cube. Then we have to multiply both by a number so that it becomes the power of 10. Then 5 cube into 2 cube we know it is 10 cube. So we have to multiply the numerator also by 2 cube. 5 cube is already here, then into 2 cube we will get 10 cube, so that the decimal can be written easily. Then 13 into 2 cube is 8 by 5 cube into 2 cube is 10 cube. It is 104 by 1000 is equal to 0.104. And what we see here? Here, in the form p by q, this q is of the form 2 raised to m, 5 raised to n. There is no 2, but we can write it as 2 raised to 0 into 5 raised to 3. Is of the form 2 raised to n, 5 raised to m. Where n and n are non-negative integers, then its decimal expansion terminates. And the last, third example, it is 7 by 18. 7 by 18 is equal to 7 by. What is the decimal expansion of 18? It is 16 into 5 you know. 16 is 2 raised to 4 into prime factorization of 8 we are writing here. It is 16 into 5. Okay. Then 7 by. By which number we have to multiply the denominator so as to make a power of 10? Here we should get 2 raised to 4 into 5 raised to 4. We get 10 raised to 4. But here only 1 5 is here. Then to get 5 raised to 4, we have to multiply it by 5 cube. 5 into 5 cube is 5 raised to 4. So 2 raised to 4 into 5 is already here, into 5 cube. It becomes 5 raised to 4 into 2 raised to 4, 10 raised to 4 we get. Then into, here we have multiplied by 5 cube, here also 5 cube. Then 7 into 125 divided by 2 raised to 4 into 5 raised to 4 is 7 into 125 is what will you get? 875 divided by it is 10 raised to 4. We get 875 divided by 10,000 is equal to 0.0875. And what we see here, if you are given a rational number of the form P by Q, where P and Q are co-prime, here they are co-prime, then the prime factorization of Q, it is of the form 2 raised to m, 5 raised to m, where m and n are non-negative integers or whole numbers. Then what we see, the next decimal expansion terminates. This is theorem 1.6, and the statement is, let x equal to p by q be a rational number such that the prime factorization of q is of the form 2 raised to n, 5 raised to m, where n and m are non-negative integers, then x has a decimal expansion which terminates. Okay, I think it is clear. Then one more topic, one more theorem, that is the last theorem of this first lesson, real numbers. What about the decimal expansion? Non-terminating recurrence. I think it is clear. Then, consider the rational number 1 by 7. What is the decimal expansion of this? By long division, 1, 7. 1 divided by 7 is not possible, it is 0. Then what we do is, we add a 0, same time we put a decimal. Then 10 divided by 7 is 1, 1 into 7, 7. This is the last year method, how to find the decimal expansion of a rational number. 10 minus 7 is 3, we add a 0, 30 divided by 7 is 4, 4 7s are 28, then 20, 2 7s are 14, 6, 60, 8, 40, then 5, 5 7s are 35, 15, 7 7s are 49, then 1 again, 10, here also we have started with the 10, then 1, 1 7s are 7, then 3 in 30, see, it is 4, 4 7s are 28, like that, it will go on. Then, see, we get, or we see that this decimal expansion is non-terminating but recurring, repeating. So we can write 1 by 7 is equal to 0.142857 bar. Since the denominator is 7, here we see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 digits are repeating. Then here if you see the denominator 1 by 7, in the rational number 1 by 7, 1 and 7 are co-prime, and the prime factor here is not 2, neither 2 nor 5, it is 7. So the last theorem of this lesson states that, that is 1.7, let x equal to p by q be a rational number such that the prime factorization of q is not of the form 2 raised to n, 5 raised to n, where n and m are non-negative integers. Then x, this is x, then x has a decimal expansion which is non-terminating. That is the last theorem. If the prime factorization of the denominator q is not of the form, or if this q does not contain 2 or 5, or 2 and 5 only, we see that its decimal expansion is non-terminating. Okay, and this chapter 1 is over, and the last exercise 1.4, and read the question without actually performing the long division. See whether the following rational numbers will have a terminating decimal expansion or a non-terminating repeating decimal expansion without actually performing. Then how will you do this? First of all, what to do is you have to check whether these rational numbers are in its standard form. What do you mean by standard form? A rational number is said to be in its standard form if q not p by q. If q not equal to 0 and p and q are co-prime, we have to check whether the numerator and the denominator, they are co-prime. If not, we have to make it as co-prime. After that, you have to do the prime factorization of the denominator and check whether it contains only 2 or only 5 or both 2 and 5 only, no other prime numbers. We can write that the decimal expansion is terminating. Otherwise, you write it as non-terminating. Okay, and just to try this exercise 1.4.